Hello everyone, welcome back again. My name is Jesse, and in this one-hour tutorial on data science tools, we'll be trying to see how to use a very powerful package called Natsort to help us to do natural sorting. So why are we using this? So in case you are working with a data set, let's say you have this data set, right? These are several CSV files, then you want to arrange them in an order. You need to work on them. If you are working on a unispace system like Linux or Macintosh, you may have issues when you're trying to do that. So let's try what I mean. So I have this my data set, which is a list of data sets. So if I go with my list, right, and I run it like this, see that this 1.7, 1.6, 1.7, right? But I want to actually sort them very well in a very nice order so that I can join them together. So how do I do that? So first of all, if you are working with Python, just go with this sorted function. So sorted, then you pass in your list. Bring it up a little. If I pass in my list, now it has sorted it. But you realize that it is 1.0, 1.5, 1.6, 1.7, then 10, then 11. So, but you realize that from here, 2 comes before 10, 2 comes before 11. So this is a normal natural sorting by lexical graphy, right? So this is how it's going to give you when you are using Python or unit-based system or any system in Python, because that's how Python functions works. So it's going to give you this issue, but that is not what I want. So in case I want to sort it from 1 to 2 before 10 and 11, then I can use another format. So the first method of solving is use your own custom function. So you can just use this particular function using regular expression. Then you are going to try and solve it with this particular format. So let's see this function. So you're just going to use lambda function. You are going to convert, check integers, if it's a digit, then you put them to lowercase, then you strip off, you split off all the numbers, then you combine them together. So this particular function is going to help us to do the same thing, right? It is a custom function that you can use to do that. So let's try that one and see. So I'm just going to pass in my natural sorts. So natural sorts. And I'm passing my values in my list. If I pass in this my list, so that it has sorted it very well. So we have 1.7, 2.0, 2.7, then 10, then 11, then 20. Right? Unlike this one that you have even 20 before 7. Right, so that is one way of doing. This is a long method. It's also a very nice package that allows you to do more of this. So let's see the second method. And the second method is going to be using Natsort. So that is the second solution. It's a very powerful package. So to install it, just go with pip install Natsort, right? So we also have Natsort for npm for JavaScript. So you can also use that one to sort it very well. So let's see how to do that. So it's going to be from, sorry for the noise, from Natsort import not sorted. Perfect. So with this particular option you can be able to use it. So let's try that one. So it's going to be not sorted. Now pass in my list. So pass in my list, perfect, has actually sorted it just like the custom function as we have here, right? Natural sorting. So that is the second method. So not sort gives you a list of functions and abilities. So let's see some of them. So the one of the things that you can do is, so let's see other things that comes with not sort. It's going to be DRL, right? So that is some of the things I can do. So let me import it first before. It's going to be import Natsort. Then let's check all the packages that come with this. So we have several of them. We have C, capitalized, first. These are all the algorithms that can use to do your own custom sorting. Then you have some interesting stuff like ASCII, UTF-5, compare, decoder, division. We have Natsorted. We have Natsort. We have Natsort keygen. That's sorted. There are several of these real sorts. So you will see some of them and see how some of them work. So let's see the first one. So in case you are also working with different packages or different versions, and want to sort them in a very perfect way, using a standard sorting scheme. This one works for only the standard sorting scheme, whereby you have your version, the main virtual version, then the subversions, right? So this works with that sort. It works perfectly. So let's see what I mean. So these are my versions. So in case I will use a default sorting package. Default sorting of Python is going to be sorted, then my version. So my version. Let's see. Perfect. So now it's sorting it as 10, 11, 8, 9, 0, 1, which is wrong, right? It's totally wrong. This is lexicographic sorting. So that's why it's given us this particular option. But I want this one first before these ones. So how do I do that? So with Natsort, it's become very easy. It's going to be not. So then, right, then I'm passing my version. So my version, you see that now it's sorting it very well. So 1.8, 1.9, 10, 11, then 2. Perfect. So that's how to work with sorting versions with Natsort. Now let's see the next method. So in case you want to sort mixed types, right? Maybe you're working with the dataset again. You want to sort them based on a mixed type, like this particular values here. So we have floats, we have strings, we have alphabets, and you want to sort them, right? So if you check for the types of these things, so let's do something like before I in miss, that's the type of that particular stuff. So it's going to be type of this my I, so that's going to print it. So we have string, string, integer, float, string, string. So in case I want to sort this particular stuff, it will be very difficult. So let's, so with the default sorted by this option, it's going to give us an error, right? So it's not supported. But with, because they are integers and strings, so it's very difficult. But with not sort, with this particular option, not sorted, to be able to sort it perfectly. So it's going to sort it based on the floats, then the strings, the floats, very well. It is very, very intuitive. So 2 comes before 5, 5 comes before 5 and 5, 6, 7, and 8. It's going to convert them in its own mechanism and sort it perfectly. So the next option is to use is the human sort. Let's try that one. So human sorting is like you want to sort by your meaning, not just by the thing itself, right? So this apple here are apple for the phone, apple for numbers, and apple for food itself, right? So if you want to sort it by their meaning, you can use that sort to help you to that. So let's try that one. So I'm going to use a default Python sorting. So it's going to be sorted of my ES1. Let's see what it's going to give to us. Perfect. So we have apple, banana, apple 13, apple 14, apple 15, banana, banana. Perfect. This is a very nice format, right? But maybe that's not what you want. So let's try with the Natsort and see. So we're going to be Natsort, Natsorted, right? Then it's going to be example one. Perfect. So that is apple, banana, apple 13, apple 14, almost like a normal sorting. But in case you want to use a human sorting on this, let you're going to use a different format. So Natsort gives you the option of doing that. So let's try that one. So it's going to be this. So from Natsort import a human sorted, right? So human sorted. Perfect. So that is human sorted. And then let's try how to work with it. So it's going to be human sorted. Then my example one. If you see that Nat has sorted it in a very simple way. So the smaller letters, the lowercase first, then the apple, then a banana, then banana, then banana, right? It's sorting it in a very simple, nice way. So that is one of the options or features that comes with Natsort. Now let's see the next option of sorting real numbers. So in case you have real numbers like this, you have a data set consisting of all of these particular data set, right? You want to sort them based on real numbers. So it's going to be like this. The normal default sorting is going to be in a nice format. So let's, it's going to almost work, right? So let's try. It's going to be example two. Perfect. So negative three, this is seeing it as negative two. So negative three can be 4, 2, can be 4, 5, and then 5.3. but if you are using that natural sorting from that sort, so that's sorted, it's going to operate in a different way. This is one of the funniest thing about it. It's going to sort it based on 2, 5. Perfect. But it's going to see this one not as negative, right? When you see that dash, that's why it's putting that in the back. So you get to want to face this issue, then you use the real sorting. So the real sorting is, it's just like the normal null sorting, but it's going to give you an algorithm of the NS. So let's see how to do that. So it's going to be from Natsort import NS. So the NS gives you the option of using your own algorithm, right? Then you can also go with real sorted. So let's try that one. So with the real sorted, it's going to be a real that's sorted by real numbers, right? So that is going to be my example two. Then perfect. So negative three can be 4, 2, before 5, and then before 5.7. This same thing can be done in this option using the normal Natsort. Natsort, then our example two. Then I'm going to go with algo RGS for the algorithm. Then I'm going to set that ns.real. Perfect. It's going to do the same thing. So this is equivalent to this, right? Perfect. So let's see the last one. So in case you want to customize it to sort it based on your own custom format, then you're going to go with the algae for the algorithm, just like we did here. Then you have NSReal, NSLocal, NSKnownKeys. Then you're going to pipe them individually. So let's try that one. So this is going to be, so in case you want to do a simple one, so you're going to supply your algorithm, you're going to pipe it perfectly. So this is how to do your own custom sorting. So that's how to do that in case you want to do your custom function. Now let's try it with an example, right? A practical example on something. So practical example. I have this particular data set I have here. Let's try this and see. So I'm just going to import pandas and work on it. So it's going to be import pandas as PD. Then let's try this. This is the data set that you're trying to work on. So df is going to be pd.read and that's for CSV. Then data set to my data set. Okay, right. So I have this data set. So if I check this particular data set, I have df.head. It's having some names, right? So let me put in column name. So let's call that names. Go to have only one distance. So ID, right? Perfect. Let's run that again. This is just the IDs, right? So I want to actually solve this particular stuff because it is not on the right order. These are wave files, these are audio files that I was working with. Then I want to join them together because it has been splitted. So I want to join them based on the numbers, otherwise I'll not be able to get an accurate data set. So if I go with this ID, I print everything out perfectly. You see that it is not in an orderly manner, right? So it's going to be very, very difficult. So, but I want to arrange them in an orderly manner because they are audio files. So how do I solve this particular issue? So to solve this issue, then I can use them. I will think of using the normal pandas sort values. It's going to be df.sort. Or let's, before then, let's put it inside and let's see what I mean. Because you may not see that this is that. So this is how it is, right? Here's a list. If you check it very well, you realize that some of them are not perfect. They are totally wrong. Like some numbers are not arranged very well. So in case I want to face this issue, let's call it as my PE list, my pandas list, right? So with this, if I go with sorted, right, P list, you may think that I solve it. Right, you may think that that's all. This is 0.12, perfect, 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 perfect. Then you come here, you see that this is 100 instead of 10. And then if you come down over and over and over, you realize that there is 10 downstairs. There is even 11, right? And then there's 119. So this is not the best method. Using a normal sorted version is not the best method because it's going to give you a lot of issues. If you go down, 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 you're going to see that even 10. See that there's even 19 here, there's 200, so it has not sorted it well because it's Python sort by arbitrary values, right? So how do I solve this issue? So we have learned about Natsort, so you can use Natsort to help us. So how it's going to be, it's going to be our Natsort, Natsorted, then my plist. So if I go with my Natsorted plist, perfect. Now it's going to sort it in a very nice simple way. So we have it like this, and we have 0.9 here, 10. And that's perfectly sorted it in a very simple, nice way. If you think that it's a data frame, so you're going to use the df.sort by values, right? And you're going to go with by then the ID, right? This particular option is also going to sort it just like the sorted here that we have here. We'll sort it like this. So if you check it, you're not still making the same mistake. You go. It's also going to make the same mistake. You may not see it like that until I open it. Let me save it as df. Let me save this particular sorting into df2. Then you save it, right? Then df2.2csv. Let's call it as sorted dataset, right? CSV. So with this, let me open it. So if I open this particular sorted DSV, which is this, you'll be thinking that sorted it all, but if you check it here, you realize that this is 100. It did not do anything, it did not sort it all as we want. It sorted it, but it's not the best because some of them are wrong. 11, like 20, 10, and all of these things. So how do we fix it? So one of the ways of fixing it is to use a NAT sort as we have learned so far. So in that case, you can put this particular stuff here that you have. It's our list, right? Our IDs that you have it as list. So let's save this one. into our own custom list. The custom list, right? This is going to be our custom list. Then we use the df.reindex. That's one of the methods, right? Reindex based on our custom list. So I go with this now. Perfect, it has sorted it well, right? So now from here, you can see that it was able to sort in a better way, not like the previous one. So let's save it into something, say df3. Then let's save it for df3 and sort. Right, let's go to end sorted.tcsv, right? Something like that. So if I open this particular file, so that you'll be able to see it well. Is it? Yeah, that's finished. Now, perfect. So that now it is sorting it in a very nice way. So we have our 8, 10, 10, 11. Perfect. Unlike the other one that we have, which is this. So that if you check this one, it's totally different. Right? This is wrong. This is that's sorted it well, but it's not the best. You have 100 before. This one is perfect. So that's how to work with it in a very simple way. So that is how to use Natsort practically. So this is not the best method, right? You can use this one to reindex it, but sometimes you get NDs. So there's a simple way of doing it. So in case you have any option of how to do that, you can also put that inside the comment section so that everybody can benefit. And thank you for watching this long tutorial. In case you have any questions or contribution, you can just put inside the comment section below, and then please don't forget to subscribe and check the link below for more. Stay blessed.